Chapter 2. Why do diesel engines rely on EGRs? Using EGRs, or exhaust gas recirculations in diesel and gasoline engines, reduces the emissions of harmful nitrogen oxide. The Environmental Protection Agency put regulations on gas engines much sooner than diesel. For many years, diesel could meet the requirements without using EGRs. Once the EPA made the requirements more stringent, the use of diesel engines required either a NOx catalyst or an EGR on the engine. NOx forms when the peak temperatures in the cylinder are high enough that oxidation occurs to the nitrogen in the air. Diesel combustion exceeds these temperatures in at least part of the cylinder on each combustion cycle. The peak temperature varies with injection timing. Retarding the timing will lower NOx production, but it hurts fuel economy. Another effect of retarding the timing is the increase of particulate matter, or PM production, which makes the engine emit more soot. EGRs work by introducing exhaust gas into the intake air, reducing the oxygen content of the gas charge that goes into the cylinder before the compression stroke. Introducing exhaust gas also reduces peak combustion temperatures, so it allows the engine to operate at lower NOx. Lower oxygen creates a problem, though. Either a reduction in peak cylinder output happens, or boost pressure increases so the fuel can react with the right amount of oxygen. If boost increases, peak cylinder pressures will increase. This cylinder pressure must stay below the engine limits. Therefore, when using EGR in the engine, a lot of components have to change the engine to meet both the emission requirements and the needs of the vehicle owner. Early on, the NOx catalyst didn't convert efficiency necessary to meet the requirements. Plus, they would have been more expensive compared to EGRs.